morning from Tombola Gold is Byron Miles. Byron, good morning.
Good morning.
Good to be speaking this morning. Give us a quick refresh, firstly, on Tombola Gold here.
Well, since last time we chatted, we've had a pretty exciting time. We've rented the Great Australian Mine plant, which has allowed us to make sure we pour our first gold bar this year. So that's another big step in the, I guess what we're trying to do, which is become a meaningful gold producer. And secondly, our most recent announcement, we've added 72,000 ounces to our resource, which is more than a 50% increase in our compliant resource. Yeah.
And this comes on the back of the acquisition here of these True North projects. Tell us a bit more about them.
Yeah, they're from True North Copper. They're gold projects themselves. They've got 72,000 ounces to 2012 draw compliant, but they also have other deposits which are very prospective. We know there's a certain amount of ounces there at the moment, and it shouldn't take too much work to bring them up to the 2012 standard. And once again, obviously increasing our reserve and our life of mine to keep going down the path of becoming a, you know, a major gold producer here in Australia.
And these deposits, they're on a mining lease, are they?
That's one of the benefits. They're on mining leases. They're mining ready. They've got their environmental permits in place. They're less than 20 kilometres away from our recent Larina acquisition. So they make a lot of sense to us. There's a lot of exciting news coming out of Tombola. Obviously, we're looking to do our first gold pour in November, increasing our resource, but we've also got a bunch of results out from Mount Scheelite, and we've also got our four follow-up holes from the exciting little Duke deposit, which obviously was 170 metres of mineralisation. At the moment, we're mining on site. We're mining ahead of schedule, and we've got circa 45 to 50,000 tonnes of decent grade ore on the ROM pad, which is getting ready to be fed to the Great Australian Mine plant to, yeah, as I said, pour that first gold bar in late November.
So as far as fast tracking towards gold production here, what happens between now and then? What are your plans?
Between now and then, we basically start shipping our ore from our ROM pad over to the GAM plant. From there, we're slowly going through a few small upgrades to the GAM plant because it's been on care and maintenance for a little while. Then to obviously start the mill up and start producing gold in late November.
Have you put some numbers out as far as how much you're looking to produce and what your production costs will be?
We haven't put some numbers out. Obviously, we've done a lot of work on them, and we're very confident it's going to be quite lucrative for the company. To say excited is a bit of an understatement. It is a big step, as you know, to go from an explorer to a producer. And this year, with the markets, have been a little bit volatile. So it's been a great achievement by the team up there. They've done a great job. And, you know, our shareholders themselves have given us a lot of support along the way with capital raises. And I feel very fortunate to be MD of a company which is just on the precipice of becoming a miner.
Good to speak this morning. Byron, thanks for your time.
Much appreciated. Take care.